All righty, boys and girls, and away we go. Not a very big load, just an ugly load. I did wiggle and jiggle on that platform. You know, the one you stand on, trying to see if that'll come off. It looks like it is removable, but it'd be a real pain if you do. So I'm not gonna bother with it. Switch my mind in a wide load mode. So basically, we take this 100 all the way down to 44, and then straight up around the bottom side of St. Louis. Normally go forwards or backwards because it could go either way. I want to go this way because it holds the doors closed, and this way it keeps the steps flapped up. I did put one more flag on the bottom of the steps, that way up high, now that they're raised up, the flag will flap high. Probably a little extra precaution more than needed, but that's fine. Steps and that like porch, for lack of a better term, I think that porch can come off, but I don't know how to take it off, and I wasn't gonna make them take it off. It doesn't really make that big a difference. I mean, I guess it does width wise, but it's wide no matter what you do. So we already had the permits ordered, so we have an annual for Wisconsin because we're always doing wides in Wisconsin. And Illinois, you're exempt because it's farm implement, farm equipment. So don't worry about it. Here's Missouri. But we already had the permit. So why bother? Load and go. Thank you. guy down there at that auction house, he was asking me what I get per mile. I looked at him, I was like, come on. Like, I'm not gonna tell you, like, what I make or what I'm doing on this one. He's like, where's that going? I go, Wisconsin. No one can believe a combine's going as far as Wisconsin. I'm like, I don't know about farm stuff, but I tell you, when it comes to trucks, equipment price is getting crazy to do stuff. So everyone's trying to get their deals where they can, get auction equipment or what have you. So a guy told me he had something brought down from up in Nebraska. He said the dude hauled it for, was a bigger combine than this. And he hauled it down, and he said it was like 800 miles, and he charged him $1,800. I looked at him, I'm like, I wouldn't even have touched it. He was like, no? I'm like, no. Because I don't haul cheap. I wasn't trying to be an ass to him, but he was trying to get me to see if he, I guess, think if I would run for that little. I'm like, no, I'm not. I'm not about that. I never disclose what I make, but I'm not, again, telling you what I won't work for. 800 loaded mile for $1,800. That's just a little over $2 a mile. The permit's got to come out of that. That's not even counting whatever deadhead miles you got. True, I'm not making a fortune on this one. Especially with the 1,000 miles I came from Albuquerque, deadhead mile to come get it. But this is going right near the house, an hour from my shop, actually. So I drop this off and bounce home and get my maintenance done, whatever work I gotta get done. Be all set and good to go. It's for the same customer. We do a lot of work for this guy, so it works out both sides. Because you can't run for nothing, boys and girls, you know what I mean? I mean, it's just, these things are businesses. You have to look at it like that. That doesn't mean you stay in one spot. Like, you go out to New Mexico and you're empty. Man, you know you're not gonna get freight coming right out of there unless you're real lucky. And auction houses know that, so if there's auction houses out there, you're probably not going to make a fortune coming out. But you better make it on the way out so you can afford to haul back for cheap. I know, I was like, no such thing as a backhaul. Yeah, there is. It's called, you work your own contracts outbound. It'd be nice if you get your own contracts coming back, but it doesn't always work that way. Then you're at the mercy of load brokers. So we got a guy like this up here in Hatley. He pays better than the broker, but not as good as our own contracts for outbound freight. Does that make sense? He's in that middle. So you get it good out, and you get it pretty good coming back. Either way, bottom line speaks loudest. Add up all the miles, you're still making money. YouTube out there, YouTube channel out there, somebody commented on. I knew of the channel prior and watch her every now and again. Talking about Big Rig Becca. She was working for a company doing flatbed work, and that company decided not to do flatbed work and focus on dry vans and reefers. So, because she didn't want to pull dry vans and reefers and spend all kind of time sitting at the dock, she told the company, I gotta go. I'm not doing it. Personally, I don't blame her. So, I knew of it, and then I got a couple comments, people asking me how I'm still doing it in flatbed, and my reply to that comment was simple, we don't work for peanuts. So, now I'm not the motor carrier. I'm obviously leased onto Whitmire Express, same as any owner-operator can come over here with flatbed experience and do exactly as I do. If you can do what I do, then you can do what I do. Of course, they blew up her comments. The only reason I'm giving her the shout out is she did just lose her job. And despite I know she's not hurting for money, her videos claim, and I'm sure she's not, you know, it's going to hurt somewhat. You're going to lose some income, so. She did reach out on a comment. A lot of her comments are telling her about me and Gentry. So, I'm not looking to hire somebody right now. I don't have a truck up and running. She needs a job pretty much immediately. If she bought a truck, she could run for Whitmire. Or if she drives a company truck, she could run for Whitmire. But that's anybody. My point I bring it up is that some people are having a hard time in the flatbed world. Some people are having a hard time in the trucking world altogether. Times are not the best. It's not like it used to be. But if you work, and sometimes you gotta do things you might necessarily not want to do. Sometimes you have to do stuff you don't necessarily want to do. And that's how you get it. There's still plenty of freight out there paying good enough. If you're willing to work, maybe stay out a little longer, work a little harder, do a little bit more, you can make it. But if you're living off the load board or trying to haul for that guy back there at that auction and wanted to see if I would haul something for cheaper than $1,800 for 800 loaded mile, you're not gonna make it. He told me, that guy was happy to have the work. I'm like, I'd have told you to give it to the next man. Difference of opinion, I get it. He's in the business of buying, selling equipment. He wants it hauled as cheap as possible. But with cheap truckers, you get cheap trucker problems. You get damaged equipment, inexperience. He wants to deal with that. Combines. I didn't exactly film it, but I went around tugging on every door, every panel on that thing. See what loose, what rattles, what can open up. Even went up top. There's little flaps up top that could be folded down. It's like a hopper up in there on the top of it. I pulled the flappers down, get it down a little lower in height. Got her down to 13.8. We're permitted for 14. Let's roll. With them flaps up, just tickling 14. Didn't have to. But I did anyway. Just little stuff like that. 95. I know I got traffic behind me and you're wanting to get around, but that's alright. I'll deal with it. High gear, you like to be quicker than 55 to get high gear. You know, 13th basically. They were in 12th if you're 55 or under for the most part. Kind of hard to watch for tree branches. Skinny bridge like this here, although this one isn't as skinny. This one, yeah, guardrail don't look nice though. More concerned for tall vehicles than shorter four-wheelers, only gotta worry about the tires. Anything tall, like a box truck, you'd have to watch that. Staircase. Well, he was oblivious, that guy. But there's enough lane to give me some room. If I hug my tires on that fog line, you're just about even with that right lane, with the double yellow. I like the room when it was wider. Ain't gonna lie. I wasn't feeling well. own business, sucking on a cough drop. Help me coughing a little bit. My ears keep popping from the hills. You know, when you get, you know, like when you're a little kid, you go up and down the hills and ears pop, you know, when you're sick, that happens more than normal. I don't like it. That even sounds funny. see that roof's got some serious trouble to it. I'll figure that out now. So the yellow roof comes up on like some kind of a mechanism. So I strapped it so it'll stay down. And I'm not that happy that my camera was angled down when I stopped. So the footage probably stunk for a while. So I apologize about that. Up a speed trap right there, creating himself into an obstacle for any wide load coming down the road. So in his interest of safety, he's actually creating the hazard of which an oversized has to avoid. That's something, ain't it? stopped at the rest area, tightened up my chains. So far, so good. Actually helps you out when you're hauling these wide loads, because a lot of times someone will tag a, if there's a car on the shoulder, give you some heads up. It's like back with that tanker, I knew there was something on the shoulder when I saw the truck. I figured plain sight the tanker seen it too. He did. That surprised me, to be honest. I figured he'd come over. He had all the room in the world. It was very obvious. I got enough flags and lights, flashing beacons and all kind of crazy crap on this truck and trailer. Well, turned out it wasn't a car on the shoulder either, but it's helpful. Just another tool in the toolbox. bypass lane. Back over messing with that barn. That's for somebody else. Lightning bolt. No cameras caught it. Off to my left. food available. Hardee's. And of course, salad, egg cups, they got them. Big loads. Lights on inside. Selling me food, I'm out of here.